Kelvin is the absolute thermodynamic unit used to measure temperature color. The scale goes from 1000 K, which is candlelight, to 10,000 K, which is blue sky, and it's tightly related to white balance. When you change your white balance in camera, you will notice the color of your shot will change, and this is basically changing the Kelvin setting of your camera. The presets are basically set Kelvin numbers that relate to the names that have been given to them, such as daylight, cloudy, and incandescent. But you can go to the Kelvin setting in your camera if you know the exact Kelvin number of the light you are taking a photograph of or that you're filming. Basically, to get a good balanced photograph, you need to match the Kelvin number of your camera to the Kelvin number of the light in your shot. If you don't, your photograph will look a little bit strange. To understand this, if you go indoors and it is lit by an incandescent light, these are the more yellow lights, and have your camera set on the daylight white balance setting, which would be a mismatch in these Kelvin numbers, the shot will appear very yellow. Whereas if you have your camera set to the incandescent preset and go outside, it will seem very blue, and once again you have a mismatch in Kelvin numbers. If you go to the K or Kelvin setting in your camera, you should have a range that you can scroll through, and you will see the color change in your shot as you change this Kelvin number. When the light has a lower Kelvin number, meaning it's more yellow, to balance this out, your camera will add more blue to your shot, cancelling out that yellowness of that lighting. If it has a high Kelvin number, it will be a much bluer light source, so your camera will introduce more yellow into the shot, once again balancing out the colors in your shot. You can also do a custom preset with white balance, and this will look at the lighting in your frame and make whatever it is in your shot white or balanced. So it will determine the Kelvin number of your photo and then match it to the Kelvin number in your camera. Now, if you want to learn more about white balance, click on this next video here. And to learn how to shoot a portrait with a difference, click on this video down here. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe for weekly tutorials in photography. I'll see you next time.